Finally, after many, many years of the essentially entire ecosystem already switching to different solutions, the React team has officially marked Create React App as deprecated. Now, in case you didn't know, which is unlikely, but still, Create React App is essentially a tool, you could say, a blueprint for creating new basic React projects, single page React applications, essentially for development, or it gives you a development server and you can also build them for production. You can add tests, unit tests if you want to, and so on. And Create React App has been super popular, especially back in 2017, 18, 19, 2020, and so on. But then better solutions came along. Most importantly, Vite came along. Vite is kind of an alternative to Webpack, though it's more than that. And Vite is a tool, a build tool, you could say. Again, it's a bit more than that, but essentially it's a build tool you can use to build all kinds of projects, not just React projects. You can build vanilla JavaScript or TypeScript projects with Vite. You can build Vue projects with Vite. And Vite also gets used by the Angular CLI for Angular projects, at least for parts of the build workflow there. It also gets used by Remix or React Router, because Remix has been merged into React Router now, and by many other frameworks as well. But you can also use Vite to spin up a pretty basic React app, for example, with JavaScript or TypeScript, simply by running npm create Vite and then choosing React and then JavaScript or TypeScript. And what you'll get is a very basic React project, which you can now use as a starting point. And you can run a development server, you can add your components there and build a React single page application. And once you're ready, you can also build it for production and potentially ship it. Now, of course, if you want to add routing, or if you don't want to fetch data with help of use effect, but you want a more capable data fetching solution like React Query, TanStack Query, as it's called now, you have to install those extra libraries into your project, which is not too difficult. Most React projects need at least React Router, I guess, but you have to install that. It's not built into that Vite-based starting project you get. And of course, you also can't just build a full stack application with that basic Vite-based React project. It's a single page application. It's meant to be used to build a single page application. Adding server-side rendering and adding a backend is definitely possible, but definitely also a bit more complicated. That's why frameworks like Next.js or Remix, again, now merged into React Router, exist. And it's absolutely recommended to use frameworks like Next.js or Remix if you want to build more complex React applications, especially if you also want to implement server-side rendering or build full-stack applications with React. Here's the problem, though. For some reason no one outside of the React team knows, I guess, the React team really does not want to recommend Vite as a starting point for new React projects. And I'm talking about a simple, plain Vite-based React project, as you can create it with npm create Vite. For some reason, they can't do that. When the new React docs launched over a year ago, there was quite a lot of confusion because the getting started docs recommend getting started with a framework like Next.js instead of just spinning up such a simple React project with Vite. And despite all the pushback they received, the React team stood their ground. And now again, in the blog post they published about sunsetting Create React App, still, Vite is, yeah, kind of mentioned, but still as a second best solution, or in the context of, hey, of course we're recommending Vite. After all, we're recommending frameworks that use Vite. Yeah, but honestly, if you're starting with React, if you're learning React, if you're building maybe a relatively simple React app, if you want to build a single page application and you want to start basic or simple, just use Vite. I'm not getting why the React team won't recommend creating basic React projects with Vite. Not everyone needs Next.js or Remix. You can always switch later. You can migrate some code from your Vite or your vanilla Vite project to a Next.js project if you need to. I just don't get it. And to be honest, it feels like the majority of the ecosystem is not getting it. And I feel like it's really bad to have the React team not recommend Vite. It might sound like a small thing, but the truth, of course, is that many people, when they get into React, will start with the official docs, with the getting started guides there. I mean, how else would you start? Sure, maybe with a course. For example, in my course, I am, of course, recommending to use a basic Vite project. That's what we do in a course. We create simple React projects with Vite. But if you're not taking a course like mine, if you're just getting started with help of the official docs, you might find yourself spinning up a Next.js project. And guess what? You'll face a lot of extra complexity, a lot of Next.js specific features. You'll not really learn React there, at least not in a straightforward, basic way. And I don't get the problem here. So yes, it is great that Create React App has now been marked as deprecated because it did use a tech stack that really is kind of showing its age and it does have some problems, though to be very honest, in my opinion, maybe not as many problems as some people out there make it seem, but whatever. It makes sense to sunset Create React App, but the obvious, the right thing in my opinion would have been to recommend a basic Vite-based React app as an alternative. NPM, create Vite, choose React, choose JavaScript. Here you go. I don't get why they're not doing it. They definitely will have their reasons. Not sure which reasons they are. Maybe they just want to do the right thing and recommend the best possible production-ready solution for complex applications. But yeah, not everyone's building such an application. And the people who do will probably know about Next.js and React Router Remix. They probably don't need that guidance. So it really feels like you're providing the wrong guidance to the wrong people. At least that's my impression here. But what's your impression? What do you think about this? Is this maybe all just exaggerated and doesn't matter at all? Definitely let me know in the comments.